Good morning. It is 9:37 Saturday morning. Cruising along at 6,500 feet. Outside air temperature at this altitude is 62 degrees. Cool and calm. It's a beautiful day to fly. Got a little bit of haze below me, but I'm in smooth air and it's feeling great. Thought I'd give a short video of the panel tour today for friends and family that are interested in seeing it. So I'm going to take the camera down. Narrate a little bit of what I get to see in here. So this is my primary flight display. Gives me my attitude, my altitude, my airspeed, and my heading. And this is touchscreen, so I've got several pieces of information I can pull up. Down in the corner here, I have traffic that I'm monitoring, so if any planes get near me, as we see one beginning to come up here about 6 miles out, kind of gives me a heads up I got some air traffic that may come into conflict. Over here, I've got my active flight plan, so it tells me what all my waypoints are. I got several in today. I'm taking a 2.5 hour flight today. Then I have my engine monitor on this side. Tells me all my primary readings on my instrument gauges. If I need to look at any of those in a bigger picture, all I got to do is touch it. Pulls up more information. So one of the things I like about this view is I can come over here and I can hit fuel calculation. Tells me how many gallons per hour I'm burning and my fuel economy. So I'm getting 15.7 nautical miles per gallon right now. So that's about 17 miles per gallon if you were equated to statute miles. Not too bad. And if I want to go back to full screen, just hit it. This is kind of where I cruise along. Over here is my multifunction display. So right now I have the FAA VFR navigational chart. And you can see I can scroll in and scroll out. So I can zoom in and see details if I want, or I can zoom out and see my entire flight plan for the day. So right here is the Austin area airspace I just passed. Here's San Antonio, that's Houston. I'm going up today to Brownwood and Coleman in that area, then headed down to the southwest, gonna go to Rock Springs and then back home. So I got about a 2.5 hour flight planned today. So several views I can have here. You can see traffic is also displayed on this one. So if I have somebody coming in close to me, I can dial it in, punch it, and it'll tell me what altitude they're at, which way they're headed, and what their ground speed is, so I can see when we're going to intercept each other, or if we're not. Several pages, I got a couple of different map options here, so there's just the kind of the general Garmin aviation map.
Descend or cross Bluebell at maintain 9000.
Cross Bluebell at maintain 9000, 34 Hotel Mike.
Then over here I have the FAA map. Right here is waypoint information, all kinds of stuff here. So frequencies, if I want to dial in a frequency, so let's say I want to talk to other pilots coming in and out of that airport, all I'd have to do is hit the frequency number, tell which radio I want it to go to, radio 1 or radio 2, hit it, and it will put it in standby. Then all I got to do to activate that is come over here, hit the frequency button,
and we're going to cross over the field.
Switches over to
that altitude.
So real easy to not only look up frequencies, but to get them dialed into the radio. Makes the workload very simple. Here's my flight plan. So it gives me my complete list of, my complete list of everywhere I'm going. So these are all my waypoints. And as I dial through, you can see it shows it on the map. And this will tell me how long the distance on that leg is, and how much time that leg will take. So all kinds of information here as well. Here is a weather page. So as you can see, I can get radar. I can zoom in. Get all kinds of information. Cloud, winds aloft, all kinds of information. Terrain, if I'm in the mountains and want to make sure I'm going to stay clear of a mountain, I have the view to do that. Here's a traffic view that's a bigger view of this over here. But as this tells me right now, I got a plane that's 6 miles out.
5774, contact Houston Center 128.65.
Play me some Rick Young. This is just GPS status information. And here's my engine monitor page if I want to keep up. Over here is my navigation source, audio panel. This is where I can control my music. So right now I have my iPad patched in. You can see I turn it off.
4 Hotel Mike, contact Houston approach 13 or 124.22.
124.22, 34 Hotel.
Or I turn it in and I got music. Now if air traffic control comes in and they start talking, it automatically mutes the music for me.
4128 Delta, contact Houston Center 128.65.
And then last but not least, this is a backup attitude indicator.
How much further
north
are you going to go?
So in the event that all of this fails, I still have a way to get myself back home.
Wait, no problem.
So this is a view out my window this morning. Got clouds below me. 793,
contact Houston Center 132.77.
Little view of the cockpit. And there I am, just having a great time today. Hard to beat this. Yesterday I went flying for 2.5 hours, and then I went golfing for 4 hours. It's a hard life to beat. Very blessed.
601, contact Fort Worth Center 133.3.
All right, turning the camera off.
Our Fort Worth Center 133.3.
So much for the navigational tour this morning.
Arctic 01133.3, if I get that right.
Hope you enjoyed it.
Arctic 01, affirmative.
We may be checking back later.
Thanks.
Goodbye.
See ya.